matamos el cerdo, por la mañana empezamos a las 10 o así, matamos el cerdo, después de matarlo lo quemamos, como vimos ayer, después de quemarlo lo abrimos, lo sacamos las tripas, las vísceras, y lo dejamos que seque la carne, porque al día siguiente, hoy, la carne al estar tiesa, corta mejor. Y eso es un poco más o menos el proceso.
There's a saying in Spain, every pig has its St. Martin's Day. St. Martin's Day is the 16th of November, and traditionally, that's the day you kill your pig. Winter is setting in, and with the cold months, the pork meat won't spoil as you work quickly to make chorizo sausages, get out the pork loin, make jamón, ham. Now, few families have a pig. Few families have a pig anymore, but some people keep the tradition alive, killing a pig in winter and keeping themselves in pork for the rest of the year. I'm in a village just north of Madrid, and although it's not the 16th of November, it's mid-January. Any winter's day is a good day for a matanza, a traditional pig slaughter.
This is the knife that's gonna kill the pig. This is Joaquin.
Hello.
It's gonna kill the pig. This is the table on which the pig will be killed, and the pigs are in there right now. I feel a little overdressed.
Yeah, you are overdressed.
Here come the pigs now. I've decided not to show the pigs being killed, but I will describe it. The animals are stunned and then hoisted onto this bench by Joaquin, his brother, and their friends who've come to help. Joaquin slips a sharp knife into each pig's jugular, and the animals are dead within minutes. And the blood, a precious resource, is caught in a bucket by Pilar, Joaquin's mum. Then the pigs are weighed.
La división de labor entre mujeres y hombres es bastante claro, ¿no? Y la tradición que es la
mujer. Todo lo que tenga que ver con la fuerza lo hacemos nosotros.
Sí.
Luego ellas tienen habilidad. En realidad la que manda y la que dice lo que hay que hacer es mi madre.
Hanging in the garage are the cured legs of last year's pigs, a recently butchered lamb that we'll be eating for lunch, and a bubbling pot of fresh pig's blood. Morning tea, once Pilar has mixed in a few ingredients.
Cebolla, ¿verdad?
Cebolla, sí. El aceite y vinagre y sal.
¡Oh, qué rico!
Ahí en un ratito ahora cuando vengan a tuya.
¡Qué divino!
¿Y eso lo comemos hoy?
Sí, y un vaso de vino.
¿Un vasito de vino? Pero ahora que sí, no puede faltar.
So, Albert and I are peeling and cutting garlic and onions, which traditionally is actually the woman's job. The men are downstairs taking the guts out of the pigs. Already there's 6 kilos of cut up onions, and this is all to be mixed in with the blood to make, well, for the blood that we're going to eat soon with a glass of wine, but also to make morcilla, blood sausage, and to go into the chorizo. Blood and onions, fresh blood from a pig killed half an hour ago. Wow, rich, delicious, raw onion.
Pilar and her neighbor Teresa, who's also come to help, get to work on the guts, cleaning and sewing them up. These will be the casings for blood sausage and chorizo. And then it's lunchtime.
Es tu cordero, ¿no?
Es mi cordero.
¿Cuándo la mataste?
Ayer. Ayer. Y me lo como hoy con mucho gusto,
¿Qué parte es este?
Como mínimo iban a tener 5.
Los sesos.
Olé.
So we're back on day 2. This is a 2 or 3 day process. It's snowing. It snowed overnight. The meat's been resting, hanging up. where it was left, the pigs with their guts taken out. Now just inside here, the family and the helpers are working away, cutting up the pig into all the different cuts, all the different parts. It's a little factory in here, a little factory with meat hanging everywhere, big buckets of meat. No part of the pig is ever wasted.
¿Y por qué lo haces todo, la matanza?
Porque me gusta y porque me gusta comer lo que produzco. Es como el cordero que nos comimos ayer.
Sí.
No es lo mismo que el que compro en la tienda.
Claro.
Es que no tiene nada que ver.
It's mid-morning and work stops once again. We eat Pilar's spicy blood sausage and Joaquin's freshly grilled, almost sweet, slices of pork cheek.
¿Cómo se llama este?
No tiene nombre.
Claro, mejor no, ¿no?
Es que luego es...
¿Cuándo lo vais
complicado
a comer?
Sí. En un mes.
En un mes.
En un mes. En un mes.
¿Se sabe que va a morir? ¿Qué piensa? ¿Sabe?
No lo sabe. Sabe que no están sus hermanas.
Sí, ¿no?
Entonces dice, pasa algo raro.
Claro.
Claro.